السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Hello dear students, I hope you're all doing well. Welcome to another video from your channel Easy Chemistry for All. This is Mr. Muad and thank you for subscribing, for sharing the channel with your friends. The channel is growing. We are at around 600 subscribers now. Thank you for that. And please continue to share and subscribe if you hadn't done so, so that hopefully many more students can benefit from these videos. قبل ما نبدأ نفس ما قلت لكم في الفيديو السابق لما نحط أي فيديو في القناة تأكدوا من السكشن حق الكومنتس إنه بعض المرات يكون في أخطاء في الكتابة في الباوربوينتس وجزاكم الله خير البعض منكم ينبهني عليها في الكومنتس فأنا أحط كومنت بالدقيقة المعنية وأكتب شو التصحيح مثلا تمام فتاكدوا من الكومنت سيكشن قبل ما تشوفوا الفيديوهات اوكي سو يا ليتس ستارت سو وي ار ان موديول 7 ليسن 2 نيمينج مولكيولز تسميه الجزيئات سو وات وي ار جوينج تو دو ان ذس ليسن وي ار جوينج تو ليرن هاو تو نيم كوفالنت كومباوندز تتذكرون في موديول 6 تعلمنا كيف نحن نسمي المركبات الأيونية الحين راح نتعلم كيف نسمي المركبات التساهمية or covalent compounds so after this lesson you should be able to name covalent compounds from their formulas using a set of rules يعني أعطيك الفورمولا وتكتب لي الاسم أو أعطيك الاسم وتكتب لي الفورمولا and name acidic solutions تسمية الأحماض اللي هي covalent or a type of covalent compounds, okay? اللي هي نوع من أنواع المركبات التساهمية, which we will see in part 2. So part 1, we are going to learn about identifying the rules, اللي هي القواعد for naming binary molecular compounds. Binary يعني مكون من عنصرين, like two elements. مش ذرتين, not two atoms, من عنصرين. Two elements, okay? And then we'll do some practice on naming these molecular compounds. So remember, when we see the word molecule, we mean covalent, okay? So these are the list of keywords that we saw in the previous lesson. I'll give you time to read it. You can stop the video and then come back and continue, okay? So guys, what's the name of this gas that you see in front of you? That comes out from factories and It pollutes the air. بالعربي حتى. وايد منكم بيقول ثاني أكسيد الكربون. In English, it's called carbon dioxide. So where did this name come from? Where did these names come from? This is what we are going to learn. We are going to learn how to give these names to covalent compounds. Okay? Okay. Sorry. So, these are the rules for naming binary molecular compounds. So, what are the rules for naming the compounds, the covalent compounds? These are the rules. Number one, write the name of the first element in the chemical formula first. For example, you have CO2. What's the first element here? It's carbon. So, we will write carbon. First element من اليسار يعني أول عنصر من اليسار نحط اسمه. Now write the root name of the second element and add the suffix IDE. Remember, the second element is oxygen. يعني لازم نكتبه oxide. Remember, in ions, when it's like an ion, we add IDE, right? So we'll do the same thing here. We'll remove the last part and put IDE. So carbon oxide. And now add a prefix to represent the number of atoms of each element. So نحط رقم يقول لي كم عدد الذرات الموجودة. الحين أنا كربون وأكسيد عرفت إنه في كربون وعرفت إنه في أكسجين. بس كم عددهم؟ كم عدد الكربون؟ كم عدد الأكسجين؟ Okay. So we are going to learn that one means mono, and two means di. So we'll see that later. Don't worry. So the name will become carbon. Dioxide. So dioxide meaning I have two oxygen and carbon meaning I have one carbon and that's what we have here. So these are the rules guys, okay? So again, the general rules are, sorry, just want to check something here. Okay, yeah. The general rules are to write the element of the name of the first element, no changes. And the second word is like writing the anion, اللي هو negative ion. اللي نحط IDE في نهاية الاسم. Okay? So remember that covalent compounds are made from non-metals only. يعني العناصر اللي بتكون عندنا بتكون بس non-metals. ما بيكون في metals. Okay? So these are the IDE. So these are the names of non-metals, common ones. Okay? So this is for like for the first element للعنصر الأول في التسمية وهذه for the second element لأنه لازم تكون النهاية IDE. Okay? So remember this is fluoride, this is chloride, this is bromide, this is iodide, this is oxide, sulfide, phosphide and nitride. Okay? الحين هاي حفظ. You need to remember it. Okay? هذا يقول لك كيف نكتب أو نوضح كم عدد الذرات في الاسم. So if you have one atom, you need to add mono before the name. So if you have one atom, you need to add mono before the name to show that you have actually one atom. If you have two atoms, you need to add di. If you have three atoms, you need to add tri. Four atoms, tetra. Five, penta. Six, hexa. Seven, hepta. Eight, octa. Nine, nona. Ten, deca. يعني مثلا إذا عندي خمسة أكسجين I will say pentoxide. البنت هاي نحطها في الأول عشان هاي البنت توضح لي إنه في خمسة أكسجين. Okay. If I have three sulfur it will be trisulfur for example or trisulfide على حسب السلفر هل هو في الأول أو الثاني. Okay. فهاي ال prefixes هاي الكلمات توضح لي عدد الذرات في المركب. That's why we use it. Okay. So now check if you have five atoms of hydrogen, then which is the correct one or the correct name? So five is penta. So you will choose pentahydrogen. If you have three atoms of oxygen, which prefix is the correct one? So three. Is tri, so we'll choose trioxygen. Now, which chemical formula represents hexacarbon? Hexacarbon. So what is hexa? Hexa is six atoms, so it should be C. Okay, guys. فهذه حفظ لازم نحفظها. Okay. So very important. That you should know the following rule. So mono means one, like CO. For example, if I want to give the name of CO, it will be carbon, الاسم الأول حق الelement, and then monoxide. Mono يقول إنه في carbon واحد. Di means two, so this is carbon dioxide لأنه في اثنين oxygen. ودائما الاسم الثاني ينتهي بIDE. قلناها في rules. NF3 is nitrogen trifluoride لأنه في عندي ثلاثة fluoride so tri means three trifluoride. Now you can ask me mister why didn't we put mono for the first element لأنه عندي أنا ذرة واحدة من الكربون here carbon here nitrogen here ليش ما حطينا mono. So this is the rule guys, we don't use mono with the first word. يعني الاسم الأول إذا كان عندي ذرة واحدة مونو ما نستخدمها لكن الباقي نستخدم. Okay, so what do we mean by that? Imagine I have let's see here. Imagine I have P2O5. هذا بس مثال يعني بس هيك يعني ممكن يكون مش صح. Okay, but it's just for the sake or let's have N2O2 for example. Okay, so the name here should be di نيتروجين داي اوكسايد. هني استخدمنا داي مع النيتروجين لانه في اثنين، لكن هني ما استخدمنا مونو لانه واحد، فالاسم الاول ما نستخدم معاه مونو ابدا، بس نستخدم معاه البقية اللي هي داي تراي تترا بنتا اند سو. Okay, so we don't use mono with the first name, but we use it. We use di, tri, tetra, penta with the other, with the first name. Okay, with the first word. Okay, so now use the rules that we studied. Okay, and try to give names to these binary covalent compounds. So binary معناها عنصرين، لأن كل واحدة منهم مكونة من عنصرين. Okay, stop the video. Write the names. And then try to solve the challenge. وبعدين تعالوا وكملوا الفيديو. Okay. CO2. CO2 we already talked about it as carbon dioxide. ليش dioxide؟ لأنه في ذرتين من الأكسجين. Okay. Now, هذه الأنسرز. SO2 is sulfur. الاسم الأول ما نغير فيه شيء. هذا هو sulfur. We don't change anything. Dioxide. لأنه في ذرتين أكسجين. NF3 is nitrogen trifluoride. CCl4 is carbon tetrachloride because 4 is tetra. Okay? So tetrachloride. Now, dinitrogen pentoxide. Dinitrogen معناها 2N وpentoxide معناها 5O. لأنه penta means 5 and 2 means di. So it will be N2O5, dinitrogen pentoxide. فتسمية المركبات التساهمية the covalent compounds is actually very easy. All you need to do is practice. So you can go online and type practice naming covalent compounds. بيطلع لكم wide exercises you can practice. Okay. أهم شيء نحفظ هذا ونعرف الرولز. We don't put mono for the first word. Okay? And that's the end of part one, guys. Very easy. Okay? Now we go to part two, which is a little bit... It's not difficult, but it has some other rules. So we'll identify the difference between binary acids and oxy acids. فعندنا الأحماض، عندنا أحماض اسمها binary acids وفي عنا أحماض اسمها oxy acids. And then we'll give names. بنتعلم كيف نعطي تسمية للbinary acids and the oxy acids. Okay? بنتعلم تسمية الacids. So, what are we looking at here, guys? So you might say this is orange, this is lime, and this is lemon, right? So orange, lemon, and this is lime, right? What does it taste like? إذا قلت لكم شو طعمها بتقولوا حامض, right? Or acidic. Now, what do we mean by acids in chemistry? شو معنى الأحماض في الكيمستري؟ إحنا نعرف الحمض أو الأحماض بس بالطعم نعرف إنه حمض طعمه حامض مثلا. صح؟ But what are acids actually in chemistry? So شو تعريف الأسيدز في الكيمستري؟ So acids are compounds that give hydrogen ions H+ in the aqueous solution when they dissolve in water. يعني إذا عندي مركب معين okay وحطيته في المي and I put it in water and then after that I can see there is H+ in water, إنه في H+ in water, معناها هذا المركب is an acid. ليش؟ لأن لما ذوبته في المي كون لي H plus ions. هذا تعريف الأسيد في الكيمياء in chemistry. This is one of the definitions or the famous definition. Okay? So there are two types of acids, guys. في نوعين من الأسيدز. الأسيدز can be binary acids. طبعا binary احنا already فهمنا شو معناها. Binary معناها ذرتين. Or oxy acids. Oxy acids مش ذرتين عفوا عنصرين. I mean two elements here. And oxy acids, which means three elements, ثلاث عناصر. Now let's talk about the binary acids. So binary acids, طبعا احنا قلنا الأسيدز لازم تعطيني H+, فأكيد تركيبها لازم يكون فيه H. So binary acids are made from hydrogen and a non-metal, عنصرين. Okay? لازم فيه hydrogen and a non-metal. it does not have oxygen. So binary acids don't have oxygen. Examples, H and Cl, H and F, H and I, H and S. فكل واحدة من هاي المركبات مكونة من هيدروجين ونون ميتال وما في أكسجين. So these are called binary acids. Now, oxy acids are made of hydrogen and polyatomic ion or oxy anion. لو تذكرون module 6 oxy anions examples NO3 minus, PO4 minus 3, SO4 minus 2. هذه هي البوليأتوميك أيونز اللي أتكلم عليها اللي هي الأوكسي أنايونز. Okay. So hydrogen مع واحدة من هذيل اللي درسناها من قبل. And it has oxygen. Look, all of these have oxygens. And these are some examples like H and SO4, H and PO4, H and NO3. في ثلاث عناصر ال H وال S وال O وهني H P O H N O so three elements okay so now we'll focus on binary acids first we'll learn how to give names to binary acids first okay before that can you please tell me which one of the following is a binary acid can choose sorry is not a binary acid So this is binary, this is binary, this is binary, this is not binary, this is oxy acid. So our answer is this. In an oxy acid, there will always be, so لما يكون عندنا oxy acids, شو اللي دائما موجود? Now we said it has hydrogen and oxygen. So hydrogen and oxygen. As you can see here. دائما في اكسجين ودائما في هيدروجين اوكي alright so now let's learn how to give names to binary acids okay so to name binary acids guy the first step is to write the prefix hydro ليش لان كلهم فيهم هيدروجين كلهم all of them have hydrogens so we'll write the first word is always hydro okay now step 2 Name the non-metal and add IC at the end. So the name of the non-metal should end with IC or IC. It's pronounced IC. Step 3. So all of this is one word. So all of this is one word, guys. Hydro plus the non-metal plus IC, one word. The second word is always acid. It's always acid. Example HCl. So the step 1 and step 2 is to write hydro وبعدين CL احنا نعرف ان هي chlorine صح فنشيل الاي ان اي ونحط اي سي so it becomes chloric so hydrochloric one word and then add the second word hydrochloric acid okay so this is how we give names to binary acids now There are other examples, for example, HF. Try to write the name of HF. Diamond. Starts with hydro, fluoric, IC, acid. So hydrofluoric acid. What about this one? HCl, we already talked about it, hydrochloric acid. What about this one? H2S. هني ما نحط داي وتراي ومونو وتترا في الأسيدز هني ما نحط داي ومونو وتراي وتترا. We don't add داي, تراي, مونو, تترا, and so on. We just follow the rules. So H is hydro, S sulfur. So we add IC to it, like the rule. So it will be hydrosulfuric acid. HI, I is going to be iodine. نشيل ال I and E ونحط IC. So hydroiodic acid. And this is how we give names to binary acids. هاي هي الخطوات عشان نسمي binary acids. تأكدوا دائما في H وفي non metal اللي هو not oxygen مش oxygen okay and this is how we give the names الحين we will go to oxy acids now just to refresh your memory these are the oxy acids okay اللي تكلمنا عليهم اللي هم النوع الثاني الحين بنتعلم كيف نسميهم الحين الأوكسي أسيدز، تسمية الأوكسي أسيدز تعتمد على البولي أتوميك أيون اللي هم مثال الـ NO3- NO2- الـ SO4-2، تعتمد على البولي أتوميك أيون. If the polyatomic ion ends with ATE, we will change the ATE to IC and add the word acid. يعني هني no hydro. ما في hydro in oxy acids. ما نحط hydro. What do we mean by this? So we don't add I hydro here. Example. This is nitrate, guys. صح? This is nitrate. If I want to make it an acid, I'll just put an H to it. إذا حطينا H بيكون هيدروجين مع بولي أتوميك أيون، فهذا صار أوكسي أسيد. فالتسمية تعتمد على البولي أتوميك أيون. The name depends on the poly atomic ion. So this one is nitrate. So the rule says remove ATE and put IC. So we remove ATE and put IC and then add acid. So this is nitric acid. يعني الاسم يعتمد على البولي أتوميك أيون. Okay. Now, this is carbonate. So, if we put hydrogen, it will become an acid. And we'll change ATE into IC and add acid. So, the ATE, we changed it to IC. And we added acid. As you can see here. Okay, H CO3. إحنا لازم نكون حافظين تذكروا من الموديول 6 اللي هو تسمية المركبات الأيونية. موديول 6, naming of ionic compounds. You should remember the names of the polyatomic ions. This is carbonate. Okay. Now, chlorate. Same thing. If we put H to it, the ATE will change to IC, اللي هو الرول, and then add the word acid. Sulfate. Because SO4 is sulfate. Again, change this one to IC, and then add acid. So sulfuric acid. Okay. Now, sometimes the polyatomic ions, they don't end with ATE. They end with ITE. Remember, NO3 minus is nitrate, but NO2 minus is actually nitrate. Right. So, إذا كان اسم المركب أو polyatomic ion ينتهي بITE, the ITE will change to OUS and add the word acid. So what do we mean by that? For example, this is nitrite. So if we put an H, because it ends with ITE, لأنها تنتهي بITE, ما بنحولها لIC. ITE نحولها إلى OUS. So this is nitrous acid. Sulfite. This is, again, ending with ITE. So we'll change it to OUS, and it will become sulfurous acid. We always add acid. دائما الكلمة الثانية تكون acid. Okay, so here we have H and SO3. تقولوا مستر, how can we know? كيف نعرف انه هذا acid او oxy anion? دائما في H والSO3 احنا لازم نكون عارفين ان هي sulfite من الدرس الثالث في الوحدة اللي طافت. And these are some of the common polyatomic ions or oxy anions اللي لازم نتذكرهم. حفظ NO2 is nitrite, NO3 minus nitrate, carbonate, sulfite, sulfate, phosphate, and so on. لكن احفظوا اللي عندكم في الدرس الثالث من الوحدة اللي فاتت. لازم تكونوا حافظينهم عشان هيك. Okay? So these are, again, examples showing you how we can give the name of the oxy acids. So ClO3 is chlorate. So ATE, we change it to IC. ClO2 is chlorite. ITE, we change it to OUS. So chlorous acid, and so on. Okay. These are some of the common names of covalent compounds. طبعا covalent compounds عندها الأسماء التسمية اللي هي اللي تعتمد على القواعد وفي التسمية العامة. So H2O, if we want to give it a name, it's called dihydrogen monoxide. لأنه في اثنين هيدروجين وفي أكسجين. But it's water. NH3 is actually nitrogen trihydride, but we know its name is ammonia. And so on. Okay? And في أسماء تكون common نعرفها إحنا يعني أسماء عامة ولما نطبق الرولز تصير أسماء مختلفة. Okay? All right, now try to practice on giving names to these acids, guys. So try to practice again. نرجع الفيديو إذا نسينا الرولز أو نريد نتأكد نحاول نسمي هاي الأسيدز اللي عندنا هني. Okay. So HI is called. First of all, this is binary. هذا binary acids لأنه ما فيه oxygen. فنذكر hydroiodic acid. هذا فيه oxygen. So it's an oxy acid. وCLO3 هذه chlorate. So الATE بتتغير لIC ويصير chloric acid. This is chlorite. هذا ينتهي بITE. فبتصير chlorous acid. This one is sulfate. ينتهي بATE. So بيصير sulfuric. Sorry, this is U. Sulfuric acid. Okay. This is no oxygen. فهذا نفس الأول اللي هو البينري. Okay. So hydro sulfuric acid. دائما نضيف hydro. Okay. Alright. So these are, or this is a summary, guys. هذا ملخص كيف نحن نسمي المركبات. Okay. المركبات التساهمية. How to give names to covalent compounds. First of all, look at the molecule. Look at the formula. Does the compound form an acidic aqueous solution? يعني, does it have hydrogen? هذا هو اللي يتكلم يعني هل هو حمض ولا لا. إذا فيه هيدروجين فنطبق عليه الرولز حق الأسيدز. Binary, this is binary and this is oxy acids اللي تكلمنا عليهم الحين. إذا no hydrogen نطبق عليه الرولز اللي تعلمناها في الأول تسمية المركبات. نحط الاسم الأول نحط الاسم الثاني نضيف IDE ونبين عدد الذرات mono, tri, tetra and so on. Okay. So you can have a look at this and read it on your own time. Okay. Now I want you to stop the video and try to solve these questions. الحين أعطيك الاسم. Okay. ويطلب منا الفورميلا يطلب الصيغة الكيميائية. So silver chloride. Now this is AgCl. Actually, this is an ionic compound. الحين دمج ال ionic compounds مع ال covalent compounds. So silver is a metal. وهذا non-metal. فنستخدم تسمية ال ionic compounds AgCl. Dihydrogen oxide. So di معناها اثنين. يعني عندي اثنين hydrogen oxide واحدة. So this is H2O. Chlorine trifluoride. هذا معناها Cl واحدة. وtrifluoride معناها 3F. So ClF3. Diphosphorus trioxide. Di معناها 2. Phosphorus is P. So 2P. Trioxide معناها 3 oxygen. So P2O3. What is the formula of carbonic acid? So when you see this, no hydro, صح؟ ما في hydro. صح ولا لا؟ There is no hydro. معناها this is an oxy acid. اللي هو النوع الثاني من أنواع الأحماض. This ends with IC. معناها كان عندي carbonate. معناها كان عندي ATE. It means I had ATE. And carbonate is CO3 minus 2. And because this is an acid, I also have hydrogen. Okay? So, the hydrogen is has a charge of plus 1. And this is CO3 minus 2. So do it like the ionic compound, okay? So this will be H2CO3. Okay? So this is how we find the formula of carbonic acid. Okay, which is the name of the acid HNO2? طبعا this is oxy acid. الحين ال NO2 شو اسمها؟ ال NO2 is nitrite. لأنها NO2 minus هي nitrite لازم نكون حافظينها. We need to memorize this. So ITE will change into OUS and then we need to add acid. So it will be nitrous acid. Which is the molecular compound name for water? So water is H2O. So عندي اثنين هيدروجين صح؟ يعني أكيد هاي غلط وهاي غلط لأنه لازم يكون في داي. أوكي؟ كم أكسجين عندي؟ وحدة سومونو. So we'll choose this one. Dihydrogen monoxide. What is the name of H2SO3? SO3 is sulfite. تنتهي بITE فلازم نحولها إلى OUS. So this will be sulfurous acid. And it's not hydro لأنه عندنا oxygen. So this is an oxy acid. اللي هو النوع الثاني من أنواع الأحماض. Which describes a binary molecular compound? Composed of two metals? No. إحنا قلنا molecular يعني covalent. وbinary معناها two elements. يعني عنصرين. Composed of a metal atom and non-metal? No. لأنه molecular covalent معناها عندي كل non-metal. So all of the elements are non-metal. Composed of two non-metal atoms? Yes. Okay. هو المفروض ما يقول atoms، المفروض يقول elements لأنه ممكن يكون عندي أكثر من ذرتين. مثلا H2O فيها ثلاث atoms، 2H وواحدة O. So it should say elements but they mean it like elements. Okay. Final question. What type of acid contains hydrogen and one other element؟ يعني بس hydrogen وعنصر ثاني، يعني two elements. احنا قلنا two elements شو معناها؟ binary. So this is a binary acid. Oxyanion contains three elements. واحدة منهم is oxygen. In binary acids, no oxygen. Okay, guys? And that's the end of the lesson. So we finished lesson two, naming molecules and covalent compounds. هاي lesson is very easy if you practice. كل ما تدربنا وحفظنا أسماء polyatomic ions كل ما بيسهل علينا الحل. So thank you very much for watching. Again, if you didn't share and subscribe to the channel, please do so. Help our channel grow. And if you have any questions, you can contact me. And yeah, please comment if you have any comments. And yeah, that's all. Take care and wish you all the best, guys. Allah ma'akum.